Hi students, today I will be dealing with magnetic field and field lines due to current in a straight wire. Earlier we had seen a current due to solenoid. Now here current due to straight wire. When current is passed through the conducting wire, a magnetic field is produced around it. So whenever current flows through a straight wire which is closed, closed means it is closed by using a battery and a resistor is there, and it is closed means it is connected. In all shorts, there is no open circuit. Then whenever current flows through a closed circuit, then a magnetic field is produced. How can we prove that there is magnetic field produced? As we can see from this diagram, see, we have put a cardboard with its center in the wire, and what we have done, we have taken some powdered iron powder or fillings and arranged it on the top of the cardboard. And when the circuit is closed, we see that the iron fillings arrange themselves in a circular or a definite pattern. Why this happens? Because there is a magnetic field flowing it. Coming to the next diagram, see, this is an laboratory arrangement of the previous example, or a straight line. Whenever we connect, the wire is connected to a battery source and it is closed. So what happens whenever a current flows through a straight wire? Definitely a magnetic field is produced. Earlier we have seen that. Earlier we placed iron fillings, but here we will not place any iron fillings. We will directly put the compass and see what is the direction of magnetic field, as a compass is a needle which points to the direction of magnetic field, or which produces deflection showing magnetic field is there. So whenever we put the compasses, it will also make us tell us that the magnetic field is in a particular circular pattern. It proves that whenever a circuit, closed circuit is there, and it is, current flows through a closed circuit, a magnetic field is produced. What is electromagnet? Electromagnet is a temporary strong magnet made from a piece of soft iron when current flows in the coil wound around it. It is an artificial magnet. See, this is a nail. You can find it at home very easily. Take a nail and wound it with a wire, copper wire, and then what? You can join the last pieces to a battery. DC battery you can easily find at home, and you can place like this, and it behaves as an artificial magnet. Why is it so? Why is it an artificial magnet? Because it's not a permanent magnet, and till the current flows in the circuit, it behaves like a magnet. If I take out the battery out, it doesn't behave like a magnet. And how will you test whether it's a magnet or not? Bring some iron fillings near it, and you can see that the that this magnet will attract the iron fillings. Simple. You can put a safety pin near around it, and it will attract the safety pin towards it. So it behaves as a artificial magnet. And if you take out this battery and try the same and try to attract a safety pin, it won't attract. So it doesn't behave a magnet if a battery is taken out. So there are two types of electromagnet. One is I-shaped and another is U-shaped. Now this is the construction of I-shaped or bar magnet. So I-shaped magnet, there is a soft iron core. You can take a nail directly or a soft iron core. And what we have done, we have wound an wire in a specified direction. Here it is, the winding is in clockwise. So this side becomes which pole? It's always a south pole. And anti-clockwise becomes a north pole. And what we have allowed in the circuit? A rheostat, a battery, a switch, and an ammeter. As we know from the previous expressions, that V is equal to IR. Voltage is equal to current into resistance. If resistance becomes zero, means voltage becomes 0. Anything multiplied with 0 is always a 0. So voltage becomes 0. We want some voltage to operate in this circuit. So what? We have put a small resistance value. So as there will be some R and there will be some voltage. So there is a resistor attached in this circuit. And whenever what we have studied earlier, whenever a circuit is closed or whenever a current flows through a circuit, it produces or it behaves like a magnet. So this whenever a current is flowing through this circuit, it is behaving like a magnet. Now coming to the next one, it's U-shaped magnet or horseshoe-shaped magnet. What is this one? As you can see from the figure, it is a U-shaped, and here what the turnings are different. Here the wire is wound in this P side, it is wound in a clockwise direction. So this pole becomes south pole and this side is in anti-clockwise direction. So this one becomes north pole. And the same thing, ammeter, rheostat and a battery. And this one also behaves as a magnet. So what is the difference? Where we need to use that U shape and where we need to use the I shape? That you will be studying in the later higher versions when you study of magnetic field. But as of now, you just remember that the I-shaped is used in relay circuits, whereas U-shaped is used in all heavier circuits like electric motors and lifts. Now, how can we increase the magnetic field of an electromagnet? One is by increasing the number of turns of winding in the solenoid, and second is increasing current. These are the two ways which you have to always remember. Second, what is the advantage of electromagnet over permanent magnet? Electromagnet has a strong magnetic field. Permanent magnet does not have a strong magnetic field. The strength of magnetic field of an electromagnet can be increased by changing the number of turns or by increasing the current. The polarity of electromagnet can be reversed by reversing the direction of current in its solenoid. So these are the advantage of electromagnet over a permanent magnet. Now these notes you need to keep it in your mind. A permanent magnet is a naturally occurring magnet. It is not strong enough. So what we can do, instead of using iron ore, we can use directly steel in the core part. And why we can use steel? Because once magnetized, it does not lose its magnetism easily. So it becomes a permanent magnet. So this is one advantage of using steel. If we use steel, it doesn't get demagnetized easily. So what are the uses of electromagnet? For lifting and transporting heavy iron in lifts, usually you can use this electromagnet. Then in scientific researches, as always, it is used. Then in several electrical devices such as electric bell, telegraph, motor, relay, microphone, loudspeakers. Now next we will be studying how it is used in an electric bell. Let's start with that. So this is a diagram which is directly taken from your book of Selina publication, and it shows, let's see what are the parts inside first. Now as you can see, here is a gong G. Then here what is the magnet used? As it is a U-shaped magnet, it is a horseshoe magnet is used, and it's an electromagnet. Then we can see a strip SS which is attached to an armature A. As you can see here, the armature A has been extended and attached to a hammer. Then the screw here is S-dash. Remember, the adjusting screw here is taken, the name is given very complicated. You can see here, the adjusting screw is given as S-dash. And the SS strip and adjusting screw, is there any gap? No gap. So this is attached. The screw is attached, or we can say it is like there is no gap between screw, adjusting screw and SS. Now this armature winding is always like one side is opposite to another. And the magnetic field is here, right? And what, see, the this armature, this winding is connected to the terminal T2, and this side winding is connected to terminal T1 through which one? How it is connected? Through this armature and SS and then adjusting screw, and then through terminal to the battery switch. Is it there anything else? Then now we can start with the procedure. How does it works? Now similarly, first, how does an electromagnet behaves as an electromagnet? How can this behave as an electromagnet? By passing current through it. So what, how can we pass a current? We have already attached a battery, so we will close the switch. When the switch is closed, the current flows through it. And when the current flows through it, how it will flow? It will flow through the battery, then the terminal T1, then to the adjusting screw S', then through SS, and it also flows through A, armature, which is connected. S, and then it goes to what? This C, and then this one, this side, and then it flows to T2 and then comes back. This is the circular pattern of it. So whenever we see that it flows from it, the current flows in this direction, what happens? Now, whenever it flows through this horseshoe shaped magnet, what happens? The magnet becomes magnetized, or electromagnet becomes magnetized. And what will it do? Whenever it's magnetized, means it will attract the iron pieces towards it. And the armature, which is made of iron, is attracted. And what will it happen? This black color, which is attached to hammer, will get attracted towards this one, the end poles of the horseshoe shaped magnet, and it will come like this, and the hammer will go and bang itself along the to the gong. So there will be a sound, or the bell will ring. And when the bell will ring, now what happens? The current that was flowing through SS screw and S', now there is a gap between them, so the circuit becomes open. So now what happens? There is a no closed circuit. When there is no closed circuit, what happens? The armature again becomes demagnetized. And when it becomes demagnetized, what happens? This screw will go back to its own position, or the hammer will go back to its own position due to the spring effect. And again, it stops working. So again, what happens? Again, if the switch is closed, again the same terminal, it will flow through the same terminal, and again it will ring, and again there is a gap, again it will stop. So this make and break circuit is used in the electric bell. So suppose in the place of battery, I use, battery is a DC source or a direct voltage. In the place of battery, if I use an AC source, AC source is what? If a battery is of like plus 5, if I use plus 5 volt, right? Battery is measuring of volts, is measured in volts, right? Voltage is measured in volts, and battery, if it is operating in plus 5, it will operate in plus 5 throughout its life. But an AC source is like a fluctuating one, plus 5 once in one phase and minus 5 in one phase. Even if I put AC voltage, it won't delay or anything, any halt its operation. It will flow as usual, because there is no effect in polarity in this case. So even if we apply an AC source for electric bell working, it will work fine. That's all for today. Thank you.